It's a sheer electoral strategy. Nicolas Sarkozy is now trying to save his presidency to get a new mandate, and this through pumping Marine Le Pen's votes. So he's attacking very hardly on immigration. And this for two reasons. He needs these votes because she's still pretty high, like 14-16%, depending on the studies. And secondly, in the second round of the election, he needs to convince these people because they are not ready, at least 1/3 to 40% are not ready to vote for him in the second round. So he needs desperately to have that kind of reservoir of votes for an hypothetic re-election.
Is this a good strategy? I mean, I mentioned briefly there is all this controversy about halal meat, which is the traditional Muslim way of slaughtering meat that's been making headlines here in France as well.
Well, it's all a bit blown out of control. The problem is that Nicolas Sarkozy is looking at how he can manoeuvre in the election campaign, who he can call on to vote there, because he's very low in the opinion poll ratings at the moment.
Right,
and whatever happens,
one of the recent opinion polls while we speak.
Whatever happens in both the first round and the second round, he's behind the main contender, who's François Hollande from the Socialist Party. So he's thinking, okay, can I move to the centre and can I seduce the centre-right voters who will vote for François Bayrou or not? And a large number of those voters will probably vote for the Socialist Party in the second round, which means they won't be voting for Nicolas Sarkozy. He can't ask any of the voters on the far left to vote for him because none of them will move towards the right. So that leaves him with the National Front of Marine Le Pen, who he's desperately trying to win back support from, because they were the ones really to a large extent who helped him become president in 2007. But since then they've become disappointed with the fact that the promises that he made then have not been honoured, so they swung back to the National Front. Because you have to remember, back in 2007, Nicolas Sarkozy had almost demolished the National Front completely and written Jean-Marie Le Pen, who was Marine Le Pen's father, off the map. Since then, the National Front has reconstituted itself, and he's trying desperately hard to win back the support, which explains why we're talking about immigration, which explains why we're talking about insecurity, and which explains why we're talking about halal meat, which is obviously something that wouldn't be a huge issue in most election campaigns in most countries.
It's and that's a pretty risky strategy he's going to, because you see the effects inside his own team right now. They're splitting, and it splits right in the middle. What Philippe has exposed is also present in his own team. So you have people like Alain Juppé, the foreign minister, who is pretty shocked by that line.
And he said so.
He has a problem with his spokeswoman, Nathalie Kosciusko-Morizet, who is also very reluctant to tread on these kind of fields. So even inside his own organization, it's a risky situation, but it means it's a risky strategy, but it says a lot to his fear to lose now. He goes like, you know, it's his last hand of cards, and he's playing them.
I think